Hello and welcome to Good Morning Pop Culture for the first time in forever. Am I right? Yeah, I am right, because I make it, so I know. Anyways, Iron Man died in Avengers Endgame, and that was depressing, but you've had 3 weeks, so if you didn't already know—
Well, good riddance, you loony!
So what are we doing today? Well, if you paid attention to the beginning of the episode, we're reviewing Avengers Endgame. And I even changed the set around just a little bit, that way then it gives off more of an avenging feel. See, I'll even do this. I'll put another Thanos, because I have two, but from different movies, different timelines. He died in the first few minutes. But before we can get to that, we have to talk about something even more important, and that's the new logo for Hollywood Studios, which is driving up a bunch of controversy. And why is it doing that? Because it's not great. But it can be. It can be good with the new font style, as long as it doesn't include characters in the majority of the park. But if they always use it with characters, then it's a bad logo unless it's on television. On television, this logo is great because it can, when you're advertising new lands, you can have different characters pop up in the circles like they've advertised it, and like they've been showing with all the new things that they've been showing us with this new logo. But if it's in the parks and it's just static, then you really don't want the characters there because they just seem like floating characters, and that's not as good as the just letters and then letting the characters be a part of the film and television division when you're advertising the park instead of just being in the park. But that's just a quick little tangent. Let's move on to Pop of the Day, and then we'll review Avengers Endgame. All right, here we are at Pop of the Day. What's the pop of the day? How about this version of Thanos? It's a pretty good pop, right? This version of Thanos. This is 2014 Thanos, technically, if you saw the movie. If you didn't...
You are a sad, strange little man, and you have my pity. Farewell.
I've already spoiled, like, half of the plot. So this is 2014 Thanos. He's armored. He's got his big sword, and like, honestly, 2014 Thanos without the Infinity Gauntlet is the most powerful Thanos we've seen. It's kind of funny. So, again, without the Infinity Gauntlet, this is inaccurate until about, like, the end of the movie, pretty much, when he takes the nanotech gauntlet that Tony made that you can see on the new Hulk 6-inch figure that they're releasing. The nanotech gauntlet, and that's the only time he wears a gauntlet in this suit. So I get why they put this here. It's to avoid spoilers, because honestly, if he had not had a gauntlet, people probably would have been like, what happened? I thought his arm was burnt and like it was stuck there. But this is a very good pop. It's pretty accurate. It's a very good sculpt. This is the only problem. It's a very good sculpt all around. I've been using it heavily for my custom figure, and you know, it's great. That's it. I'm not going to put it back in its box, so let's review Avengers Endgame. Alright, here we are, ladies and gentlemen, at the review. We're going to end the video with a number score, but first off, I do want to quickly summarize the plot. So in the first act, it's your classic end of the world, like, the world ended, everybody's dealing with how it is, a rat gets Paul Rudd, well, Ant-Man, out of the Quantum Realm, which was funny. Thor becomes fat, and that's just a way that he grieves with his... just being stupid and being bad at being a king. But it's okay, because in the end, he realizes that he's not a good king, and he says, hey, Valkyrie, you're the queen now, I'm gonna go join the Guardians of the Galaxy, which is gonna be great when we see Guardians of the Galaxy 3. That movie should hopefully be outstanding, and that will likely be the last MCU movie that I'll care about after Into the Spider-Verse. Not Into the Spider-Verse, that's what it is, practically, really. Let's be real. But, anyways... once we get to time travel, I Love You 3000, everyone, did we cry? I didn't, I don't have a soul. But we get to time travel, that happens. I saw it as an absolute win. I thought that time travel was an absolute win. I thought that it was great for anyone who has seen all the MCU films. If you haven't, then you were probably lost within the first couple minutes of it. Because you were like, who's she? Who's the lady with the magic? People that were like, I'll skip out on Doctor Strange, were probably really, really not happy with the fact that it was actually more important than Captain Marvel. Anyways, and it was more important than Captain Marvel. I'm sorry. Captain Marvel was barely in the movie, like for 15 minutes. Ant-Man was a bigger character than her. Basically, the only movies that you needed to have seen is all the Avengers movies to know all the characters. Thor: The Dark World, Guardians of the Galaxy, Infinity War, Doctor Strange, and both Ant-Man movies. I think that's all you would have to see if you wanted to completely enjoy this movie. If I'm right. If I'm not, whatever. I've seen it twice now. Both times were great. The first time, the movie felt really, really quick. The second time, it dragged in a couple scenes, when they were in Asgard. Those scenes usually dragged a little more. And Black Widow's death didn't have as much of an impact because I knew that it was going to happen, and I was like, okay, whatever. Tony's death hit harder because I had to watch him be with his daughter the whole movie and then be like, oh, he's going to die later. Great. And then he died, and I was sad. Than I was the first time that I watched it, and I was like, this is really sad. Rescue is in the movie. That was cool. The whole third act is the best MCU third act we've ever had in the whole MCU, and that is the truth. Why is that? Because it is literally everything we wanted as fans, but more. Because everybody wanted to see all the Avengers lined up to kick Thanos' butt, but instead of just getting all the Avengers, we got the Ravagers, the Wakandan soldiers, apparently the Skrulls were mixed in there. We got the wizards, we got literally everybody, all the armies, just coming to fight Thanos' army, and it was outstanding. Captain Marvel came in and saved the day, sort of. She kind of just fended off Thanos' fleet for a little while, and then helped them out. Of course, Tony takes the stones, probably using some sort of nanotech, just to kind of take the stones out of the gauntlet, put it on him, and then he snapped his fingers, saying, I am Iron Man, and the theater was in chills. I was in chills both times that I watched it. I just bumped the camera, I'm sorry. It was just outstanding. The movie is great. It is a very, very meticulously thought out and good conclusion to the MCU, and I am very okay with how it went with it all. Is it my favorite MCU movie? No, it is not. The movie above me is. Yeah, Civil War is my favorite MCU movie. Is it my favorite superhero movie? No, The Dark Knight is. But this is definitely my favorite MCU movie. Endgame is probably my second favorite. And then Infinity War. And just since I'm on the topic of Endgame, will it beat Avatar? I sure hope it does. If it doesn't, that would be hashtag depressing. But other than that, ladies and gents, this just needed to be a semi-quick episode because next week we're starting summer, we're going to start doing mini-series of this, so basically there'll be parts 1, 2, and 3 of a lot of things. We're going to have theme park, we're going to do like a bunch of episodes about theme parks, just reviewing every major theme park in Orlando, so the 4 main Disney parks and the 3 main Universal parks. Just to preface that, I'm a Disney boy. There might be some bias, okay? I'm going to Universal for the first time in about a week. I'm very excited. I will be reviewing it as I go along. I will enjoy myself, and then when I come back, I'll be like, okay, time to review this boy. But next week, hopefully it'll be about movies. We're just going to talk about my favorite movies of all time, do Pop of the Week again. I need to buy more pops, just kidding. What will be the Pop of the Week next week? I think I have one. Yeah, I think I have one. Cool. Anyways, that was the video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit the bell for notifications. That way you're not always notified, because the next video will likely be on him, probably. Not the pop, but like the figure. And then after that, it will likely be on Iron Man. And Cap, I still have to start on that figure. And then more figures to come. There'll be a lot of figures this summer. Hopefully I can finish a lot. There will be Good Morning Pop Culture. There will be vlogs. Vlogs are happening. Summer vacation. Perfect time to vlog. Just be like, hey yo, Lo Gang. Just kidding. I'm stalling to get that 10-minute ad revenue. Just kidding, I don't have that many subscribers. We gotta get there, though. So, subscribe, comment below, like, all the things, and as always, be positive.